Hey folks, Alan Saunders, Doug Biega here at Peterson Event Center. Just getting set for tip-off. About 45 minutes, still pitting Syracuse go here. Old-fashioned Big East style game. What are you looking forward to for this one, Doug?
And I'm just looking forward to the game, you know what I mean? This does bring back those old Big East memories of the 80s, like you referred to, the 90s, and even into the later days. Obviously, when Pitt plays Syracuse, and anyone plays Syracuse, you look to see how they solve that zone. So that's what I'm looking at tonight.
Yeah, I think Pitt's in a lot better position to be able to figure that out than they were the first time they played Syracuse. Then they went up to the Carrier Dome. There's a lot on top of just playing the zone when you go up there. It's a big arena, a big atmosphere, big crowd. And I think some of that got to Pitt as a young team. But I think in the second half of that game, they showed they can be productive against the zone. They can get Ortiz Tony, assuming he plays, he's warming up right now, into the middle of that zone. I think that's a good matchup for them.
Well, you hit on something very important right there. A lot of people think if you have to solve a zone, you have to hit your perimeter shots. What I always thought to do as a coach was to attack that zone, a little high-low action, get someone in the top of the foul line, the elbow extended, get the ball in there, hit that short corner, hit those little seven-footers, dive downs from the foul line, things such as that. And then you'd be surprised when those short shots start falling, the defense collapses a little bit and those perimeter shots fall a lot more easily.
The other thing, it's hard to defensive rebound when you're in a zone sometimes.
It is.
Now, Syracuse has a 7-2 center in Pascal Chukwu, but I think Terrell Brown, Kenneth Chukwuka, Ortiz Tony, I think they can have a better performance on the offensive glass than they did last time Pitt played Syracuse. And if Pitt can get some easy second chance baskets, that's another way they can collapse that zone down if Syracuse is worried about giving up offensive rebounds.
Absolutely correct. And you hit on something again there. Like, that is a big thing, to hit that offensive glass. It is difficult, no matter your size, to rebound out of a zone. There is no man accountability, so you're looking for someone to block out. Sometimes you get lost doing that. So if Pitt goes with that fearlessness, they attack the offensive glass, they really have nothing to lose. It's going to be a great atmosphere. That will help as well.
Sold out crowd here. Should be another fantastic environment. And Pitt's wearing its retro gold uniforms. What do you think of those?
I never understood why they wear anything else. I'm sure I speak for a lot of people. I don't know why the football and basketball teams don't wear these exclusively. They're beautiful.
I'm actually not a huge fan of the white ones they've worn, but these yellow gold ones are
they're pretty special
looking.
Yeah.
The blue and white piping is makes you want to go up to the Fitzgerald Fieldhouse to watch this.
Absolutely,
one.
It does.
All right, that's it from the beat. Alan Saunders, Doug Biega, Pittsburgh Sports Live. Tip off in about 40 minutes.
Enjoy the game.